Hi and welcome to a very nerdy video. Someone's asked me to do a video showing how you put your Boba Fett costume on. So here it is.
Firstly, what I recommend and what I always do is obviously lay out the entire kit. So one, you can see that you've got everything, and two, it's all very accessible because once you start getting kitted up, you can't bend over very easy. So it's always good to have it on a table, or I've got it here on my couch in my summer house.
Now, as you can see, I'm already in my jumpsuit.
Here you can see my boots and my spats. Not nifty little trick on the spats. What I've done was I put a popper on the side. As you can see, popper's on, goes round, comes back round, velcros over the top of the popper so you don't see it. But what it does is when you're wearing your costume and you're walking about, means your spats stay exactly where they should be, both of them. So you haven't got worried about them revolving around all the time.
Right, so as I already said, already got my jumpsuit on, I've got my boots on, I've got my spats on. Easy peasy, let's carry on. What I've done is again, put poppers on the back of my cod and on my suit. Just easily poppers on. One, two, three. There we go. Just turn my pocket round. So that's on. Same with the butt plate. Poppers on. I've got a popper on that side. Sorry about the heckler in the background.
Your butt plate.
There. Next we go for the journeyman protector belt, which is the belt worn by the ancient journeyman protectors, which were the old law enforcement. If you're into the real history of Star Wars and the extended universe, which I'm actually not. Now next, I'm going to put my knee armour on. Obviously there's another belt, but once you put the other belt on, it's a little bit restrictive, so I tend to do that quite later on. So I'm going to put my knees on now. What I've done is, on the back there's a bit of Velcro, and I've got this strap with a little hook and eye system on it. So what I do is Velcro on my knee, pop that over, strap goes around the back, and then the eye goes underneath and hooks on, and then we have one knee. We go for the second one, same thing again, Velcro on the knee, around the back, and the hook and eye hooks on. Sorry about the filming. Now obviously remember that the darts go on the outside. Apart from the fact it's obviously incorrect to have them on the inside, when you start walking you'll whack your darts off. Right, next I'm going to put on my harness. Which holds the jetpack. There's many harnesses. There's a simple belt that goes around your chest, over the shoulder straps and things. I just found that very restrictive. Made me not be able to breathe properly for about 3 days. So what I did is I've got a copy of the original scuba tank type harness. Goes over your shoulders, round your waist. It's got this rail on the back where the jetpack sits onto. Then over your shoulder, you've got these straps with hooks on, with eyes on, and at the top of the jetpack, there's simply a couple of bent over hooks. Bottom of the jetpack, there's a elongated bent over hook, which sits on that rail. The back plate sits over the entire of this, so all you see is this bit. So just pop that on. Sorry about that little Ewok that just walked across the screen. Pop the clip on the waist. Put it down as far as it will go. There we go. These simply go over your shoulder. Alright, so, and we're ready for the flak vest to go on. There's my flak vest. The battery's not in for the display at the moment, so don't worry about that too much. But there's a display board inside. It just velcros up, and I've permanently sewed my Wookiee scalps onto the shoulder. This is when you start to need an assistant. One who's currently wrecking my bar. Right, as you can see, Ben has just pulled through my straps so that they're through the top of my flak vest with the hooks on it. So the costume's not very easy to put on without an assistant. I forgot to do my neck seal, obviously. Unlike the Stormtrooper, Boba Fett's neck seal does up at the front.
Sorry about the car.
Now we do that up.
Car,
there we go. And then the overshoot goes and tucks in underneath the vest. Then what I normally wear is one of these cream balaclavas. When you're wearing your Stormtrooper costume, if you've got one, you normally wear a black one, so it just blends in with the undersuit. With this one, wear a cream one, so it blends in with all your flak vest. But I'm not going to do that for this demonstration. Right, next we've got the back plate. As you can see on the back, it's got two slots for the harness to come through. On the top of my, goes over the shoulder, I've got Velcro, which is where the collar then will attach. So what I'm going to do is get my little assistant to pop that on. As I said before, what happens is it slides in with this D shape around the jetpack, so the rail harness, so the rail comes out the side of side. And then you get your assistant to poke your harness straps through. There, Ben's pulled them through. You can probably just about make out that the D-rings are hanging out the back. So the next thing is, I put my neck brace on, my neck collar armour. Permanently fix the cape to the top so it's screen accurate. What I normally do here is I have a mirror. Sounds very vain, but it helps you get it lined up properly. So I'm just going to do. What I do is I stand in front of the mirror, get one on one side, one on the other, and then you just got to simply line it all up. As you can see, go around each shoulder, and it's attached, and it's all lined up.